Hello, YouTube, and welcome to this week's episode of Brainstorm, where we give you a glimpse into the world of science. Our top story comes from the world of biochemistry, where scientists at the University of Glasgow are investigating inorganic biology. They've already been able to produce an inorganic membrane very similar to those of bacteria. Just this initial breakthrough has a number of interesting applications, with the ability to perform multiple chemical reactions separately on such a small scale. However, the long-term goal is to eventually develop this into a completely separate form of life that can grow and evolve. If successful, this opens up the possibility to inorganic life on other planets. Either way, it will offer us tremendous insights into the origins of life on Earth, as much of the research is simply letting complex chemistry happen and observing. Our next story, if you haven't already guessed, is from the world of evolution. A team at Johns Hopkins University are synthesizing yeast chromosomes as a research tool. The synthetic parts of the genome had some modifications, though. Software went through and streamlined the genetic code and put in place a mutation trigger called scramble. Scramble was initiated, and different yeast populations were put in different conditions, and some adapted quickly. The hope is to eventually synthesize and apply this system to the entire yeast genome, allowing for the quick evolution of organisms to serve various functions. And our final story is just awesome. Researchers at Carnegie Mellon University are studying woolly mammoth blood. In particular, they wanted to study the mammoth's hemoglobin to find out if there was anything in their blood that helped them resist the cold. They did, in fact, find differences when comparing the mammoth DNA fragments to their closest living relative, Asian elephants. So they created mammoth hemoglobin using the DNA fragments and found that it was less affected by temperature change than that of elephants or humans. The researchers will eventually identify the exact mutations in order to create synthetic blood products for people with conditions like hypothermia. Hope you enjoyed this very special episode of Brainstorm. You see, tomorrow, September 20th, I'm turning 18, so I thought I'd indulge myself a bit in this week's story selection. If you would like to do something for my birthday, nice comments are always welcome, and the donation page for Doctors Without Borders is still open. You could also share and favorite this video, or if you make videos yourself, give me a shout out. Anyway, thanks for watching, and see you next week.